Combining several chemicals to form a desired product is called synthesis. In this experiment, we will synthesize potassium trioxalatoferrate trihydrate, also known as the green crystals. First, 5 grams of the starting material, ferrous ammonium sulfate hexahydrate, are weighed out. The chemical is dissolved in some water and a few drops of 6 molar sulfuric acid are added. The solution is placed on a hot plate with a magnetic stirrer to dissolve. Then 14 milliliters of 1 molar oxalic acid are added. While this heats to 75 degrees Celsius, another beaker of just water is placed on a hot plate to warm. Once the reaction reaches 75 degrees, it is removed from the hot plate with tongs and the precipitated solid is allowed to settle. The supernatant liquid is decanted off and the remaining solid is washed with the clean water from the warm beaker and again decanted. 10.5 milliliters of 2 molar potassium oxalate are added and the solution is heated to 40 degrees Celsius. Again, the beaker is removed from the hot plate. 5 milliliters of 5% hydrogen peroxide are slowly added and mixed into the beaker. No yellow solid should be left in the beaker. If there is some, more peroxide can be added. The reaction is again heated to 75 degrees, and more 1 molar oxalic acid is added until the solution turns clear. It may take about 14 milliliters. The beaker is removed from heating and allowed to cool. After removing the magnetic stir bar, 10 milliliters of ethanol are added, and the beaker is covered with parafilm, and a wooden stick is inserted to serve as a nucleation site for the crystallization. The beaker is stored away, and the crystals will form over several days. In the next experiment, the crystals will be isolated and analyzed. The percent yield of a reaction gives an idea of how successful the synthesis was. To find percent yield, you'll need to first calculate theoretical yield. The theoretical yield is the maximum amount of product that could be obtained based on how much starting material was used. Consider this generic reaction. Two reactants are combined to make a product, and they all have a stoichiometric coefficient of 1. If 0.9 moles of A and 2 moles of B are combined, they can only possibly produce 0.9 moles of C. All of the A will react, leaving some B left over. Whichever reactant runs out first in this scenario is labeled the limiting reagent. Once the maximum possible moles of product are determined, the theoretical yield is calculated by multiplying by the molar mass. In the green crystal experiment, ferrous ammonium sulfate hexahydrate, or FAS, is eventually converted into potassium trioxalatoferrate trihydrate, or PTFT. This experiment was designed so that FAS would be the limiting reagent. There are many other reagents involved in this reaction, but we'll just look at this simplified equation for clarity. Let's work through a calculation of theoretical yield. For this example, 4.222 grams of FAS were weighed out as starting material. We'll convert this value to moles by dividing by the molar mass. This leaves us with units of moles FAS, and we'll convert this value into moles of PTFT by using their stoichiometric ratio, which happens to be 1:1 here. Moles of FAS cancel out to leave us with moles PTFT, which can be converted to a mass by multiplying by the molar mass of PTFT. If this reaction went to 100% completion, we should obtain 5.289 grams of PTFT green crystals. The theoretical yield can be calculated before the reaction is performed, but to find a percent yield, you'll need to know the actual amount of product obtained after the reaction. In this example, 3.642 grams of PTFT green crystals were obtained after the reaction. Dividing that value by the theoretical yield and multiplying by 100 gives us a percent yield of 68.86%. You shouldn't be surprised to get a percent yield far below 100%. In fact, it's nearly impossible to get a 100% yield. For this reaction, 68 is pretty good. Since your green crystals will be collected during the next experiment, this week you'll only be able to calculate the theoretical yield, but make sure to calculate the percent yield once you do isolate your crystals.